Hey, welcome back to the channel, everybody. My name is Prestige, and today we are going to be talking about the Armory Unlocks system in Modern Warfare 3. We're currently playing the full version of the game since it's in New Zealand officially available, and the global rollout will happen later tonight for everyone else around the world. And this Armory Unlock system is causing quite a stir online currently. So what I'd like to do today is give you official details on what it does, how it works, and of course to put everyone's minds at ease. So in order to get access to the Armory Unlock system, you first need to reach rank 25 in the multiplayer. Yes, there are still 55 regular ranks that you need to go through, and along the way you're going to be earning perks and weapons and other pieces of equipment. The Armory Unlock system is going to work hand in hand with the regular ranking system. So along the way, while getting to level 55, you're going to earn plenty of weapons, field upgrades, streaks, perks, and pieces of equipment. But Armory Unlocks will also allow you to unlock weaponry, aftermarket parts, perks, equipment, field upgrades, and kill streaks. All of the things that you're going to find throughout the Armory Unlocks are things that you're not going to earn while going from level 1 to 55. So throughout the time that you're ranking up normally and playing the game, you're going to want to activate one of these Armory Unlocks and work towards it while you're playing. And this is where the confusion comes into play. There are so many people saying that since it's tied to daily challenges, you're going to have to wait until a new day in order to unlock another item. Thankfully, this is not the case. So if you take a look at my daily challenges, they'll reset in about 9 hours. But I have 3 challenges available. Get 35 operator kills, blind 2 operators with flash grenades, and get 7 operator kills with snipers. So okay, cool. That will count as 3 different daily challenges, and it will go towards my covert sneakers. Once you've completed all 3 daily challenges, a brand new bonus challenge will unlock, and this can be completed infinitely. I've seen people saying that it never goes from 0 to 1, and that is the intention. You can complete that bonus challenge as many times as you want in a single day, meaning you could, theoretically, depending on how much time you have, complete every single Armory Unlock in a single day if you really wanted to. The bonus challenge, by the way, will never change. If you're playing multiplayer, the bonus challenge will require you to win a match. If you're playing zombies, they will require you to complete contracts. The biggest bummer about this system as of right now, especially for those of you that may be playing right now, traveling to New Zealand, there is currently a bug that is preventing that bonus challenge from actually applying points to the Armory Unlock. This is not affecting every single player. It's only affecting specific players for some reason. But once again, this is a bug. I'm sure that they're going to fix this one very quickly because getting to level 25 doesn't take that long. I know that there are a lot of differing opinions online right now currently about this system, but I'm going to try to look at it from an optimistic point of view. And I really do feel like this can evolve into something really cool moving forward, especially when we start getting into the live seasons. If you scroll all the way down to the bottom of the All page, you can actually see that there is a calling card, emblem, and a sticker to unlock by getting 30, 60, and 90 daily completions, respectively. This is a lot, obviously, and as you're going to play throughout the seasons, you're going to be getting wins, you're going to be getting contract completions. But the point is, we aren't restricted to things that we would just normally see by progressing to level 55, like weapons and field upgrades and perks. This can quite literally be anything. We could get camo patterns, we could get operator skins, we could get, and maybe this is just wishful thinking from me, an evolution to what we saw originally with the Prestige Shop back in Black Ops Cold War. Which, by the way, they've actually not talked about Prestige Mode or what happens in our first season. I'm still under the assumption that it's going to be pretty much identical to what we've seen before, but who knows? Maybe they're going to surprise us. All I know is this isn't just restricted to these items that we're seeing at the beginning. The beautiful part about this is, and it's also the dullest part, daily challenges are there every day, and whether you're doing the challenges or not, you're still going to be getting wins and losses. So you're always working towards something, even if it's a minuscule item like a calling card or an emblem. But what if they did over-the-top items? What if they got even more in-depth with character customization? I know we don't have operator leveling anymore like we saw originally in Vanguard, which is such a shame to be completely honest. But what if they gave us the ability to earn golden gear, platinum gear, Damascus gear, Orion gear? What if they did throwback camo patterns? You know, they could really just dip into anything that Call of Duty had in the past and bring that forth for us to actually complete by simply playing the game. And this is the best avenue for them to do it as of right now. I love the fact that they could. We don't have any confirmation on whether or not that's going to be true. But once again, just like I was saying about maybe, you know, going forward with the Prestige shop, we don't effectively have that anymore. But we could even do Prestige emblems. Throwback Prestige emblems would be cool. Being able to select those and customize those at our own will. So while people may not like what we're seeing right now, while people might be upset that this is how you have to unlock specific things, it doesn't really bother me. I'm actually quite excited to see what this could potentially evolve into. Because the most unfortunate thing that could happen is that once you unlock all the stuff that's available, the 58 items that are there, it just goes away. And honestly, that would suck. If you just unlocked everything and then that was it, like the calling card, the emblem, and the sticker, that was it. They had no other plans for it. That would really suck. I'd love to know what y'all think down below in the comments section. If there were specific items or gear or camo patterns or calling cards, emblems, charms, anything, what would you personally like to see come back? I know that I'd love to see some throwback MW3 stuff. Honestly, it'd be pretty cool if we saw other operators come into this so we can unlock them. For example, like General Shepard. Like, Shepard was in the campaign, so it'd be kind of cool to see him as an operator. Same thing with, like, Laswell. And if they wanted to take it a step further, it'd be cool to see an unlock to take us back to the OG MW2. So, like, what if there was an operator skin for Shepard that gave him the OG Shepard look? What if there was a skin for Makarov that made him look like the OG Makarov from MW2? Just some cool ideas I'm thinking about. They can even do skins for our pieces of equipment and streaks. We've seen them do skins on the throwing knives and stuff, so it'd be kind of cool if they did that, took it a step further. But I'm just throwing ideas out there, especially since Modern Warfare 3 really is a celebration of nostalgia, and I think that that could definitely fit well specifically in this game. But I'd really, really like to know what y'all think in the comments section below. Leave your ideas. What could they possibly do to add to this system? What could they do to evolve it? I don't necessarily think they need to just stick to daily challenges. I don't think they need to stick to just getting that win over and over again to rank up the bar to earn the item. It would be cool to just see them add unique challenges, especially because if you're selecting the challenge, it kind of throws me back to the Infinite Warfare days where you can select what challenge you wanted to do before the beginning of the match. I liked that. I really did. Just being able to do those faction challenges was pretty cool. So I think that there is so much that can happen over the course of the next year with this system in particular, and it's not even a main focus, to be completely fair. But I would really love to know what you all think about that in the comments section below. If anybody from Sledgehammer happens to stumble across this video, please feel free to steal all these ideas, put them in the game, having like an OG Shepard, an OG Ghost, an OG Price, OG Soap, all those different characters would be fantastic to see. I'm not entirely sure if that would ever work, but if we're talking nostalgia, we're talking OG, and they've done a good job recreating these maps in Modern Warfare 3, so I'm looking forward to see what happens here. Leave your thoughts in the comments section below. Leave your ideas down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. Drop a like if you enjoyed. Subscribe for more, and I'll see you all in the next video. Peace.